Hello Mariners, hope you guys are doing well. So in this video we are going to learn about Ror cards, that how to look Ror card, what answer we have to give and how we have to give and how to pretend that which light is this. So please be till end and do like, share, subscribe and do share with your friends so that they can also get benefited with these videos, and don't forget to subscribe. So well, starting with any cards, let me tell you something, like there are some short forms in the cards which we have here. I am showing you that what does PD stands for. PD is your power driven vessel, VL is your vessel, STBD that is stands for starboard, SV sailing vessel, AC that is your alter course, NUC not under command, RAM that is restricted in ability to maneuver. I hope everyone is much familiar with these terms. There is no confusion. If you guys are confused that what does this means, it's better you just read your ROR, and before starting this card, make sure you know all the lights for each and every kind of vessel. Then CVD, it stands for constant by draft, LT that is light, and FORD it's forward, ADL that is additional, and VRT vertical, HOR CHED that is stands for horizontal. These are the some terms when you are using your card, when you are referring your cards, you will come these short forms. So don't get any confused, because short forms, what does it stands for, you must having a card that says, or else this video will be much helpful. You will get this video in three part. The first part I will covering from 1 to 100. So well, without wasting much of time, let's begin with the card number 1. So the first thing you need to know, that what is means, what are the lights for power driven vessel, for sailing vessel, fishing vessel. So make sure your lights concepts are cleared. So let's see how we are going to look. So the first point is that we are looking a vessel, that is the first point we have to say, that how we are seeing the other vessel. So as for this scenario, we are seeing a power driven vessel that is less than 50 meter underway, seen end on. So what is end on? End on means we are seeing right ahead. The next point, that what we have to do, means the own vessel, what action we will take. So as per that, so the second thing, one shot blast, we will give one shot blast on our vessel and we will alter course to starboard. That is a head, as per head on situation, each vessel will alter our course to starboard and pass port to port. So that's what we are doing in here. Now the third is, there is no day signal for the power driven vessel and it's making way, one long blast, stop, two long blast with 2 second interval. Now look for card number 2. So how we are looking this card, so that is as per this, this is a simple power driven vessel, less than 15 meter underway and seen from starboard side. It's a green light, it means we are seeing that vessel from the starboard side. If we are seeing a power driven vessel on the starboard side, then it's our responsibilities as per rules and regulations, collision avoidance, that we will maintain our course and speed. No day signal for that vessel. The day signal is always, we are talking about the vessel which we are seeing. And the fourth point, we have to say the sound signal, what the sound signal the vessel will give. That if the vessel is doing a making way, then one prolonged blast. If that vessel is stopped, then it will be two prolonged blast with 2 second interval in between. It's a simple, more or less you will find there are total 4 kind of sound signal that you will come to know, or else at the end of the video I will say that all the 4 signals and you can make a note, so that will be much easier for you to remember your ROR cards. Okay, now let's move to card number 3. As you are seeing, this card is exact ditto of your card number 2, but the difference is that in that card you are able to see the green light and here we are able to see the red light. Red light means a port. That means, now first point, that is a power driven vessel less than 50 meter underway, seen from port side. Next, one shot blast, alter course to starboard. We will give one shot blast and we'll alter our course to starboard. Then there is no day signal for that vessel. Fourth point, we have to call as a give a signal, that is making way, what the signal the vessel will give, that is making way, he will give one prolonged blast, and if that vessel is stopped, it will give two prolonged blast with 2 second interval in between. Now look for card number 4. The card number 4 is the ditto copy of your card number 1. The difference is that here you guys are able to see the two masthead light, that is two white light. So that means a power driven vessel seen end on. The chances maybe is that there is two cases, that is probably the vessel is 50 meter or more, that is underway, or the vessel may be less than 50 meter towing or pushing underway, or 200 meter or less. Then as per that, what signal is what we have to do, we will give one short blast and we will alter course to starboard. There is no day signal, like you may get confused that we need to give a day signal because the other case is towing. But if the tow exceed more than 200 meter, then we will put your one diamond, that is in the forward part. But as the length of towing is less than 200 meter, so therefore no day signal at all. Now therefore the point number four, if it's a making way, one prolonged blast. If stopped, two prolonged blast with 2 second interval in between. I hope you guys are getting. If there is any confusion, feel free to comment and I will respond to your messages. Now let's move to card number 5. Card number 5 is a power driven vessel that is 50 meter or more underway, seen from starboard side. As from the light, it is clear. You guys are able to see the two masthead light. That is, if there is only one masthead light, it means you guys that the vessel is less than 50 meter. But two masthead light, it means the vessel is more than 50 meter. Here there is no chances of towing, as it's a clear indication that two masthead lights are at a different position, and we are seeing from the starboard side. Now, as per the starboard side, we will maintain our course and speed. There is no day signal for that, and vessel making way, one prolonged blast. If stopped, two prolonged blast with 2 second interval in between. Now the card number 6, that is power driven vessel less than 50 meter or more underway, seen from here it is saying starboard side, but this is wrong. We are seeing a vessel from the port side as it is a red light. Okay, now the second point, that is one short blast alter course to starboard. One short blast alter course to starboard, no day signal, making way, one prolonged blast, stopped, two prolonged blast with 2 second interval. Please don't get confused. In the videos you are seeing, it's written as a starboard, but that will be port. Now here comes a tricky light, that is as per 7. Now you guys are able to see two masthead lights. So the conditions may be that this vessel is probably 50 meter or more, but less than 100 meter. The chances that a vessel is at anchor, seen from ahead or stern. You know the lights for the anchor. Now the second point will be as a power driven vessel probably 50 meter or more underway, seen end on outrange of the side light. That is, you know the characteristic masthead lights are always visible from more far ahead, more distance, more ahead than the other condition. The point number C would be that a power driven vessel is towing or pushing less than 50 meter underway to 200 meter or less. The same condition, that is outreach of the side lights. So as per that, what action we have to take, that is as per if the condition is A and B, so we will simply give one short blast and we will alter course to starboard. But as for the C, we have to wait for some time and we need to check the side lights, what side light is visible. So after looking for the side light, then we will take action. Now as per 3, the day signal, so we will look for the point number A, that is saying anchor. So as per that, we have to display the one ball in the forward part. And for B and C, there is no day signal at all. And point number 4, that is as per the responsibility, what conditions is doing, we will give. So the point what we have to say, we no need to get confused, no need to give any answer rather than whatever written in the card. So it will be simple. Here it's a confusion system, so we will say, we will give a sound, the vessel will give a sound signal as per the possibility, or you can answer as per that only. Now here the chances will be automatically reduced as there is no chances of a towing. So the condition may be that a vessel is probably 50 meter or more, but less than 100 meter at anchor. Remember the word anchor, seen from port side. Why I'm saying from the port side, because if a anchor light, the forward light will be higher than the aft one. But in a normal condition, the forward light will be lower than the aft light. So now the second condition is simple, as I just quoted, that a power driven vessel probably 50 meter or more underway, seen from starboard side, out range of the side light. And then the signals for that. Now the stay signal. Now the action we will take, that is, we will give one short blast and we will alter course to starboard. And for B, that is for a power driven vessel, it will be simple. We will maintain our course and speed. Now the day signal the vessel will display. So that is, as the anchor light, the vessel has to display one ball in the forward part. And for normal power driven vessel, there is no day signal at all. Now for signals, that is, he will give a rapid ring for of bell for 5 seconds. Additionally, short plong and short blast may be sounded. And for making way, it's a power driven vessel, show one short blast, and if that vessel is stopped, two plong blast with 2 second interval. I hope it's all clear. Now let's have a look to rule number, I mean to say card number 9. It's a very tricky card, you can say that. I'm on surveyors mostly used to ask this question. So it's a single white light. So what are the condition? What may be the condition? The first condition will be that it's a power driven vessel or it's a sailing vessel underway seen from stern. It's a power driven vessel or a sailing vessel seen from stern. The second condition may be that a power driven vessel less than 50 meter underway outreach of side lights. Now the C, that's for the all round lights. The condition may be the vessel less than 50 meter at anchor or a vessel under oars, and oars is your chappu. Then the third point may be a power driven vessel less than 12 meter, speed not exceeding 7 knot. The fourth may be a power driven vessel less than 12 meter out of range of the side light. The fifth conditions may be the sailing vessel less than 7 meter. So for that we have to give the sound signal, we have to take action. What action we will take? So that's for the first point, we will simply give one short blast, we'll alter course to starboard. For the B, we have to look for the side lights, we have to look for the side lights. And for point number C, we will look for your... So now the terms come for the what we will do. So that is, for the first, we will give one short blast, alter course to starboard. B, that is, as per the side light when sighted. The C condition will be, as per we will decide, as per the 1, 2 and 5th, where we will give one short blast and I will alter course to starboard. For point number 3rd, a port, blow maintain course and speed. And right ahead and starboard bow, one short blast, alter course to starboard. For 4 number, as per the side light when sighted. Here only two condition will be light. As for the for 3, that is the day signal, that is, we will give as a anchored, so one ball in the forward part, and others there is no day signal at all. And for the signals, that is, as per the possibilities, don't get confused, be cleared. Now let's move to card number 10. What a card number 10 say? It's a yellow all-round flashing light. So yellow all-round flashing light, it's a simple, it is a air cushion vessel. So it's an air cushion vessel less than 50 meter in non-displacement mode underway seen end on. One short blast, alter course to starboard. There is no day signal, and there is, and the signal is, that is, one long blast assumed making way. Same port starboard situations. One day you were able to see a yellow light. So it's an air cushion vessel less than 50 meter in non-displacement mode underway seen from starboard side. We will simple, it is considered as a power driven vessel, so we will maintain our course and speed. No day signal, and the sound signal is one long blast vessel assumed to be making way. You have to say this all things also, that is, vessel is assumed to be making way or underway, whatever the situations, you have to say that. Now the card number 12, it's the same port starboard difference. So that is, air cushion vessel less than 50 meter in non-displacement mode underway seen from port side. For air cushion vessel, don't get confused, that is, it's a displacement mode or non-displacement. All air cushion vessel will be on non-displacement mode. Now what action we will take? We will give one short blast, we will alter course to starboard, because as per the crossing situation, it's my responsibility. Then there is no day signal for air cushion vessel, and the sound signal which that vessel is going to show is your vessel. He will give one long blast and vessel is assumed to be making way. Now let's look for this situation. As this is an air cushion vessel, non-displacement mode underway seen from starboard. It's a stern because you are able to see only one white light. The second condition is that a air cushion vessel less than 12 meter in length and in non-displacement mode underway out range of your side light. So for that, we will give one shot blast ultra course to starboard, and as per the side light is not visible, so we'll wait till the time when the side light is visible and we will take the action accordingly. There is no day signal, what the signal, sound signal the vessel is going to give is that one plong blast. It's a standard one plong blast and vessel is assumed to be making way. Now let's move with the card number 14. It's the same situation, same scenario, just the masthead light at the white light is just a little bit with the starboard side. The same situation, same thing, no difference. So it's a very clear, that is vessel, air cushion vessel, non-displacement mode, underway, seen from stern. Second point will be the air cushion vessel, less than 12 meter, in non-displacement mode, underway, out range of the side light, and seen from starboard side. One plong blast, ultra course to starboard, maintain course and speed, there is no day signal, and then one plong blast and vessel is assumed to be making way. I hope you guys are getting all clear. So now let's look for this card, as it's simple. And the first card is from the starboard side. That's a vessel, it's a normal condition what we are seeing. So it's a simple, that's a air cushion vessel in non-displacement mode, underway, seen from stern. The second point will be the air cushion vessel, less than 12 meter, in non-displacement mode, underway, out range of side lights, and seen from, it will be port side. And say it's card written as a starboard, but it will be port. And now let's move for the what action we will take. So as for first condition, we will give two short blasts ultra course to starboard, and for the second condition we will give one short blast and will alter course to starboard. The first condition will be alter to port, and second will alter course to starboard. There is no day signal, and a one prolonged blast and vessel will be assumed to be a making way. I hope all cleared you guys. Okay, now let's move to card number 16. So it's a simple, your power driven vessel. Since the side lights are combined in the lantern, so definitely the length will be less than your 20 meter, underway, seen and on. The second case may be that a power driven vessel less than 12 meter, underway, masthead light displaced from the center line and seen and on. One short blast, alter to course starboard, no day signal, making way, one prolonged blast, stop to prolong with 2 seconds. Now let's move to card number 17. What it says, it's a simple card, that is a power driven vessel towing less than 50 meter, underway, tow 200 meter or less from the port side. Now here the two white light in a vertical line, so it's an indication of a towing vessel. Now as per side light, so we will give one short blast alter course to starboard. There is no day signal, and the third point is one prolonged blast, two short. I'm saying third because this is the third signal which we are going to use. Now let's move to card number 18. So card number 18, that is a power driven vessel less than 50 meter or underway, tow 200 meter or less from the port side. We will maintain our course and speed. Sorry, it will be starboard side. We will maintain our course and speed. There is no day signal and one prolong and two short. There is no confusion. There are some error in this card, as I had used this. I had downloaded it from the online site and there is some error. But don't worry, I will say the correct wording. So don't get confused that it is written port and why I am saying starboard, because you will come to know it's a very simple. Don't get confused. The wording I am saying, that is correct. The reader, some things written is maybe wrong. Now let's move to the card number 19. It's a simple power driven vessel towing, underway, seen and on. There is two condition, that is less than 50 meter, tow exceed 200 meter, probably 50 meter or more, tow 200 or less. So on for the both the condition, we will give one short blast alter course to starboard, no day signal, and it's a one prolonged blast, two short, that is your RV signals. Next card, that is 20. It's a simple, a power driven vessel, probably 50 meter or more, underway, tow 200 or less from the starboard side. If the masthead light will be 3 in a vertical line, then definitely to exceed will be more than 200. So you guys are getting this. If doubt, then please feel free to comment. We will look over that. Then second, we will maintain our course and speed. There is no day signal, and we will give the other vessel will give one prolong and two short. Now again same, it's a power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more, underway, tow 200 meter or less, seen from starboard side. we will simply maintain our course and speed. There is no day signal at all because it is less than 200 meter tow. That's why there is no day signal, and that vessel will give one long blast and two short. Guys, it's a simple things. Just we need to recall it. Just we need to remember the lights, and we need a revision. So this video will help. Definitely, it's gonna help. So just let me know how it's helping you guys. Now let's move to card number 22. It's a power driven vessel, probably 50 meter or more underway, tow 200 meter or less, seen from port side. Again, we will give one short blast and we will alter course to starboard. No day signal, and the sound signal is one long blast and two short blast. And that's then we will next move to card number, that's a card number 23. That's a power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway, tow 200 meter or less, seen from port side. Port because it's a red. Now one short blast, alter course to starboard, no day signal, one long blast and two short blast. Guys, if you guys are feeling that this video is helpful, then please do message, do comment, that have a look on that. So that now card number 24. So it's a powered in vessel towing probably 50 or more underway, to exit 200 meters, seen from starboard side. Simply, it's a starboard side, then a normal crossing situation is his responsibility. So we will maintain our course and speed. So as tow is exceeding 200 meters, so now there is a diamond shape. We'll gonna display one diamond in the forward part, and the sound signal is one prolong and two short blast. Now that's the turn for the card number 25. It's a powered in vessel towing probably 50 meter underway, to exit 200 meter, seen from port side. One short blast, alter course to starboard. Again, we will give one diamond as it's a more than 200 meter, and sound signal one prolong and two short blast. Let's move to card number 26. Don't get confused that there is one more white light in your starboard side. It's a green light. It's an error in the card. So the how we are seeing that it's a powered in vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway, to exit 200 meter end on. One short blast, we will alter course to starboard, that is as per head-on situation. One diamond and it is exceeding more than 200, and sound signal is your one prolong and two short blast. Now let's look for the card number 27. Powered in vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway, to exit 200 and seen from starboard side. Since we are seeing from the starboard side, so as per the rule number crossing situations, we will maintain our course and speed. So point number 2, we will maintain our course and speed. The day signal, that is one diamond, and sound signal one prolong and two short blast. Now let's move to card number 28. It's a simple power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway, to exit 200 meters, seen from starboard side. May we maintain our course and speed. Simple, the day signal will be one diamond, and point number 4, that is we will give one prolong and two short blast. Now here we will move to card number 29. Card number 29, it's a simple card as you had seen previous, that is 28. It's instead of green, it's a red. So a power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway, to exit 200 meters, seen from port side. One short blast, we will alter course to starboard, one diamond and one prolong and two short. There is no confusion, the indication, the 4 points we have to tell at all time. So here comes with card number 30. That is again simple card, no confusion at all. A power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway, to exceed 200 meter, seen from port side. Then we will give one short blast, we will alter course to starboard, and day signal, there is one diamond, and your sound signal, it's one prolonged blast and two short blast. You will get all these things, so you will be able to learn just one by one. Now you guys are able to see a yellow light. So yellow light, it means a towing light. So simple, a powered in vessel towing underway, seen from stern. One short blast, we will alter course to starboard and keep that vessel to our port, and we will pass clearly. one diamond if to exceed 200 meters, because it's not cleared by seeing the stern that what is the length of the vessel. And sound signal is one plong and two short blasts. Guys, don't get panic, you will come to know all. Just view this video twice or thrice, that will be much helpful for you. Okay, card number 32. You might get a confused that two green lights, then what does it mean? So it's simply a power driven vessel towing less than 50 meters, because there is no second mast headlight, underway with tow 200 meters or seen from side, starboard side. Then we will maintain our, because both the lights are displaying your, that's not a big deal. So maintain course and speed. There is no day signal. And towing vessel will give one plong and two short, and towed vessel will give one plong and three short blast. So simple that. Card number 33. Again, same as card as the previous, just instead of green, it's red. So a power driven vessel less than probably 50 meter, underway with tow 200 meter, or seen from the port side. One short blast, alter course to starboard, no day signal, vessel tow one plong followed by two short blast, and towed vessel will give one plong followed by three short blast. Again, a same light, instead of two white lights, here it's a three white light. So therefore, it's a simple power driven vessel towing less than probably 50 meter, underway with tow exceeding, here we are confirmed the tow has been exceeded by 200 meter or seen from the port side. Now it is seen from the starboard side. So what we will do, we will maintain our course and speed, one diamond each on the towing and towed, and sound signal as prescribed. Again, same card number 35 is similar to 34, no difference instead of green and red. So this is a power driven vessel towing less than a probably 50 meter, underway with tow exceeding 200 meter or seen from the port side. One short blast, we will alter course to starboard, one diamond each on towing and towed vessel, and the sound signal that is for the towing, one plong followed by two short, and towed one plong and three short blast. Next, your card number 36. So that is a power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more, underway with tow exceeding 200 meter or less, seen from the starboard side. Maintain course and speed. There is no day signal. Towing vessel, he will give one plong blast followed by two short blast, and towed will give one plong and followed by three short blast. The red light which you are seeing on the upper end, that's not a red, it's a white. It's an indication that a vessel is more than 50 meter. It's an error in the card. Okay, please. Card number 37. Simple, same lights, same things, no difference. You will come to know once you will read these cards twice or thrice. Then let's see. A power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more, underway with tow exceed 200 meters or less, seen from the starboard side. Maintain course and speed. We will maintain our course and speed. And there is no day signal for that vessel. Now, towing vessel, one plong blast, two short blast. Towed vessel, one plong and three short ballast on your main vessel. Now the card number 38. A power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more, underway with tow 200 meter or less, seen from the port side. If we are seeing other vessel from the port side, then it's our responsibility to keep clear. So we will give one short blast, we'll alter course to starboard. There is no day signal. Now the next towing vessel, one plong and two short blast, and towed vessel will give one plong and three short blast on the main vessel. Next card, we will move with the card number 39. So it's a power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more, underway with tow 200 meter or less, seen from port side. One short blast, we will alter course to starboard. No day signal. Towing vessel will give one plong and two short blast. Towed vessel will give one plong and three short blast. That's all. Now we will move with the card number 40. So what 40 is saying, that it's saying a power driven vessel towing that is probably 50 meter or more, underway with tow exceeding 200 meter, seen from starboard side. What we will do, we will maintain our course and speed. The day signal, it will be one diamond each on the towing and the towed. Each on towing or towed, because it's more than 200 meter and both vessels are displaying the lights. So sound signal, one plong, two short, one plong followed by three short, that is for the towed. Next, that is card number 41. So what 41 is saying, that a powder-driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway with tow exceeding 200 meters seen from the starboard side. It's a starboard side, okay? It's exceeding 200 meters because we are seeing a four white lights. We will maintain our course and speed one diamond each on the towing and the towed vessel. And for the sound signal, the towing vessel will give one prolong and two short blast, and towed vessel will give one prolong followed by three short blast on the main vessel. Next, we'll move with the card number 42. So what it's saying, that it's saying as a powered-in vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway with tow exceeding 200 meters seen from the port side. Port side because it's a red lights. One short blast, we will utter course to starboard. One diamond each on the towing and the towed vessel. Towing vessel will give one prolong and two short blast. Towed vessel one prolong and three short blast on the main vessel. I hope you guys are getting all these things. Okay, now we will move with card number 43. I hope you guys are getting all these things. If in confusion, if any suggestion, feel free to comment. Next is your power driven vessel towing probably 50 meter or more underway with tow exceeding 200 meter seen from port side. One short blast, alter course to starboard. The third is your one diamond each on towing and towed vessel. Towing vessel one prolong blast and two short blast. Towed vessel one prolong followed by three short blast. Now let's move with the card number 44. It's saying the powered-in vessel pushing ahead less than 50 meter underway seen from starboard side. Simple condition. We will maintain our course and speed. There is no day signal at all. And next, what we will do, we will give one prolong blast and two short blast. Just this indication because it's a less than 200 meter and vessel is only one. Next is your card number 45. It's a simple card, that is powered-in vessel pushing ahead less than 50 meter underway seen from the starboard side. One short blast, alter course to starboard. There is no day signal, one prolong and two short blast. I hope you guys are aware about there is a difference between a pushing and a towing. Towing means it's pulling a vessel, and pushing means it's a pushing a vessel. It's in a like a composite unit. Okay, it will be indicated as a same vessel. Once you will see from the now, let's move to card number 46. What card number 46 is saying, that a power driven vessel pushing ahead probably 50 meter or more. Now how it's 50 meter or more, because we are able to see the two masthead light now. Then we will maintain our course and speed as per normal situations, and there is no day signal at all, and on we will give one prolong, that is followed by two short blast on the main vessel. Next, we will move with card number 48, that is power driven vessel pushing ahead probably 50 meter or more underway seen from the starboard side. We will give one short blast, alter course to starboard. No day signal for this condition because it's less than 200 meter. Next, it's your one prolonged blast followed by two short blast. Next, we will move with card number 49. What it's saying, that it's saying that a powered-in vessel pushing ahead probably 50 meter or more underway seen from the starboard side. One short blast, we will alter course to starboard. There is no day signal, and we will give one prolonged blast and two short blast. It's a very simple, like you guys may get confused that previously we are using a towed, because here lights are seeing, but the masthead lights are very less. So that's a way of learning that it's a push. Okay guys, now this is the last card number 50. As I had said that I will make a two to three videos, but since the first video has extended till 30 minutes, is more or less 30 minutes, so that's the condition why I'm ending this at 50. The next video I will continue from 50 to 100 and so on, but it's all depends upon you. If you feel that the videos are useful and it's interesting, then please comment, or if you are interested in giving any suggestion, all suggestions are accepted. Just tell me that what are the errors you need to be corrected for my next video. I will work on that. Okay, now let's move with the card number 50. It's a simple, that's a powered-in vessel towing alongside less than 50 meter underway seen end on. One short blast, alter course to starboard, no day signal, one prolong and two short blast. So that's all end of card 51 to 50 I had covered. Next, say on, and we will look for also day cards and cardinal cards. But I need your support, guys. Please do support so that we can learn more and more through it.